Hello students. Now we'll discuss a module number 2, solution of non-homogeneous differential equation by inverse differential operator. And even we try to calculate a particular integral from the given equation. Here we discuss type 1. In a type 1, we are going to get a particular integral pi of the form exponential. Exponential will be given like e raised to ax divided by f of d. If this is given, then what will be the solution for this to go for a particular integral? Because whenever we take a non-homogeneous differential equation, first we need to calculate a complementary function, then we need to calculate a particular integral. Altogether, that will become a general solution. Therefore, for this, we need an equation. That equation is given like this. E raised to ax divided by f of d. That is equal to e raised to ax divided by f of a. So, here we can observe where d being replaced by a. And we can say this f of a should not be equal to 0 because of basic mathematical operations. If it becomes 0, then the denominator will be 0, then the whole value becomes infinity. So this care we need to take. Then after that, what to do? We should take care that f of a should not be equal to 0. But it is not in our hand, we cannot deny these things. Suppose if the value of f of a becomes 0, then what to do? Then the same thing, e raised to ax divided by f of d is equal to, then e raised to ax divided by, this denominator has to be differentiated once. What is denominator here? Denominator is f of d. This has to be differentiated, and as a compensatory part, x, the variable x has to be multiplied to it. Then this will become the way to get a particular integral. Again, the condition remains same, where f dash of a should not be equal to 0. This should not be equal to 0. That is condition. Suppose, again, if this f dash of a also becomes a 0, then what to do? Then we will be getting e raised to ax divided by f of d, that is equal to x into e raised to ax divided by f dash of a we have right now. So once again the denominator will be differentiated. Then as a compensatory part, once again one more variable x will be multiplied to it. Then it becomes x square. Again the condition comes, that is f double dash of a should not be equal to 0. If it is again 0, then this process will be continued to get a particular integral. Okay, so we'll concentrate on few note here for which type of functions this is applicable. If we take this result means these things we can observe here. These results holds good for following functions, few of the functions. So first I'll take function. If the function is e raised to ax pattern, directly it is applicable without any problem. Okay, if the function is of this pattern, e raised to ax plus b, then also this is applicable, because d is going to be replaced by a, and that a will be taken from exponential part. Okay, the power of an exponential, and which is also a coefficient of a variable x. So this a will be taken as a replacement for d. Therefore, here also we can pick that a from here, then the process will continue as usual. One. Second, for any constants k, how we can apply it for k when we are expecting an exponential? So this k will be taken as k into e raised to 0 times x. If you take e raised to 0 times x, automatically it becomes 1. Then k will be equal to k. And for a replacement, we take d being replaced by a, and that a will be 0. Okay, next. A raised to x. A raised to x function can also be taken under this process. How it is possible? We say it should be exponential. How? What is the relation between a raised to x and an exponential? How it will be connected? So let us see that connection, how it is. So we can see a raised to ax, we do one thing. We'll write e raised to log. It is like a square and square root, cube and cube root, log and exponential of a raised to x. And we know that as per the logarithm property, this becomes log a into x. Okay, log a into x. So this we will be taking as log bx. So while solving, what to do? D being replaced by a, but instead of a, what we do? Here we take d being replaced by b, and that whole b is nothing but log a, means our d will be replaced by log a. So see how this function is connected to an exponential, and we can apply this process. Next, sine hyperbolic ax pattern. It should be exponential, but it is sine hyperbolic, and directly we can connect a sine hyperbolic as e raised to ax minus e raised to minus ax divided by 2. Okay, similarly we can take cos hyperbolic ax also. Cos hyperbolic ax also, then that can be taken as e raised to ax plus e raised to minus ax divided by 2. So like this, we can apply this process for exponential of this pattern, direct exponential, any constants, a raised to x pattern, then the hyperbolic patterns we can utilize for these things. Okay, so now we'll take one example and we'll proceed with the solution here. How to get a solution? We'll take example like solve the function. The function will be how? The function will be like f of d of y is equal to pi of x, and this pi of x will be here exponential. Okay, so that care we need to take. So it is called as type 1. Type 1 means what? Where exponential function will be there as pi of x value, and there automatically it will be taken as type 1, d being replaced by a. Okay, we'll take one example. 6 times d square plus 17 times d plus 12 y is equal to e raised to minus 3x. Okay, you can see this is directly an exponential function. So very first, what to do? We need to get complementary function as well as particular integral here. To get a complementary function, we need roots. So first we take it as an auxiliary equation. What is auxiliary equation? 6m square plus 17m plus 12 is equal to 0. Then we need to find out the roots of these equations. So what we do here, if you use Calci, you can use, or else we can use a conventional method. So if you multiply the numbers, it should be 12. If you add or subtract, it should be 17. So which are those values? If you take 9 and 8, if you add, it will become 17. Then if you take 12 into 6, it becomes 72. So if you multiply these two, we will be getting the same number. Okay, therefore it will be taken as 6m square plus 9m plus 8m plus 12 equal to 0. Okay, from these two I'll be taking 3m common, then it will be 2m plus 3 plus, I'll be taking 4 common from this, then it becomes 4 plus 2m plus 3 equal to 0. Therefore, 3m plus 4 into 2m plus 3 is equal to 0. Therefore, the roots are m is equal to minus 3 by 2 and minus 4 by 3. These are the roots. With the help of these roots, we can construct a complementary function. What is complementary function? C1, we know that if the roots are real, if the roots are real and different, and if the roots are complex, then the way to get a complementary function differs. Here we can see the roots are real and different. Therefore, it is C1 into e raised to minus 3x divided by 2 plus C2 into e raised to minus 4x divided by 3. So, this is complementary function. Then we need to go for a particular integral. What is particular integral? That is pi of x divided by f of d. Therefore, what is pi of x? E raised to minus 3x divided by f of d. What is f of d? 6d square plus 17d plus 12y. That is equal to. Okay, here we can see d being replaced by a, and that a is equal to minus 3. A will be taken from an exponential itself. Okay, so replace. Therefore, e raised to minus 3x divided by 6 times minus 3 d square, replace d by minus 3, plus 17 into minus 3 plus 12. Okay, plus 12. Therefore, this is equal to e raised to minus 3x divided by, we can see it is 6 into minus 3 square is plus 9, then it is minus 17 into 3 plus 12. Altogether, if you calculate, it becomes e raised to minus 3x divided by 9 into 9 into 6 minus 17 into 3 plus 12, that becomes 15. So this is called as particular integral. Therefore, general solution is equal to complementary function plus particular integral. Therefore, general solution y is equal to complementary function, that is C1 into e raised to minus 3x divided by 2 plus C2 into e raised to minus 4x divided by 3 plus pi. Pi is particular integral, that is e raised to minus 3x divided by 15. So this becomes a general solution of this given example, where the exponential is given as a value of pi of x. Thank you.